from my heart and from my hand. Why don't people understand my intention?
This is bizarre, and this is getting really weird. The article halfway looks at it and is halfway serious, saying, I may be Bill Hicks, basically. I mean, this is really getting weird now, man. No kidding. If that guy is Obama's dad, I am a Easter Bunny jet pilot from the planet Uranus. It is just ridiculous. No resemblance, no genetic resemblance. It'd be like saying I look like, I don't know, Newt Gingrich. I look nothing like Newt Gingrich. It'd be like they said, Newt Gingrich is Alex Jones's dad. I mean, you'd say, well, he doesn't look anything like him. Well, it's the same thing with Obama. Looks nothing like him. It'd be like saying, I don't know, the Queen of England's my mother. Oh, actually, that'll start a new conspiracy theory. Actually, Bill Hicks is my mother. You know, there's that conspiracy on the internet that I am really Bill Hicks. Yes.
That's a good
one. Goes to the extreme of saying everybody's an actor. And again, when the government lies so much, people lose confidence in everything and don't believe anything. And then, like, schizophrenics are the new philosophers and just believe everything's a conspiracy when it's not. Because I can assure you, I'm not Bill Hicks. I'm not Ritter. They'll do these face things where they go, look, it's 100% face match. And all they are using is some paint program to say it's their face match. I mean, just amazing. But what do you expect? You're going to have that end of things when the government is saying there's no drones or no bullets being
bought. Clip. And then we'll come back and get into Obama engaged in his authoritarian revolution, saying you didn't build that, your small business. You didn't paint that painting. You didn't compose that song. I didn't host this show live tonight. The crew didn't get this whole show together. No, ladies and gentlemen, the government did it. The government, not my father. My father didn't get in bed with my mother and then change my diapers and work and take care of me with her. No, the government, in an immaculate conception, climbed on top of my mother, and that's how you got Alex Jones. I am the son of Obama, Bill Hicks. So let's go ahead and go to this tape.
The whole world is a stage, and each of us players upon it. I mean, as Bill Hicks, I know that better than most.
Well,
I'm being sarcastic.
I understand that, and I agree, but today
Now, joining us for the balance of the hour is Kevin Booth. And, folks, he's really here because he was a producer for Bill Hicks. We're just going to go come clean, since everybody on the internet's exposed us. We're running scared right now. Folks, I am Bill Hicks. And I joked the other day and said that. People said he accidentally said it. I accidentally just said it again right there. And, you know, it's actually kind of mean to the family, folks. Bill really did die of pancreatic cancer. And that's not why Kevin Booth is here. He's here to talk about American Drug War, too. I just want to be honest with folks. Actually, Kevin Booth is Bill Hicks and Sam Kennison. He was good friends with him as well. And, folks, Richard Pryor didn't die. I'm going to be honest. I'm not Bill Hicks. I'm Richard Pryor. Okay? I'm like Michael Jackson. They took the pigment out of my skin. And I'm Richard Pryor, folks. I'm also St. Jerome and George Carlin and a Vatican assassin. So you're going to talk about American Drug War II, which actually wasn't produced by you. It was produced by Bill Hicks. Kevin, do you want to come clean with the fact of how you were the mastermind producer behind my transformation?
Well, even though both you guys were still alive at the same time.
I'm Tupac Shakur, too.
We started the plastic surgery in the out at the porta potty at the public access station. We had a team of plastic surgeons behind the porta potty in the dumpster back there making the transformation.
But I'm sure you have sacredcowproductions.com. I'm sure this has been going on for years now, man. They're digging through my like birth records and stuff to prove I'm Bill Hicks.
Yeah, I was amazed. I went on YouTube the other day and searched it, and there's hundreds of videos now. So it's definitely, it's taking off. This one's taking off.
But it's mean to the family. It's mean to the family.
Yeah, I know. I mean, what do you, I don't know.
And then, you know, when you got Russell Crowe calling you up asking if you're really Bill Hicks, you know it's gone too far. I can't handle it, man. I'm living in a Twilight Zone episode. I'm sorry. You want to address me as Bill now, Kevin?
All right, Billy.
No, but doesn't it kind of make you mad being good friends with Bill and being there when he died to hear all this?
You know, what makes me mad are just some of the people out there that aren't real crazy about you. Like some of the Bill fans that are not so crazy about you that are saying, you know, Kevin owes us some sort of...
Oh, they cut the feed right there. They didn't want us to hear the Bill Hicks thing. That was us cutting the feed. Kevin, your audio cut out. Say that again. Yeah. Bill Hicks fans say what?
Yeah.
My fans say what?
You know, I just get a lot from like the Bill Hicks fans that aren't all that crazy about you always saying, well, Kevin Booth owes us some sort of an explanation for his association with Alex.
But I'm Bill. I mean, well, how would you not keep associating with me?
I know they got the eye scanning to prove it. They can prove it. They've got everything. The one guy goes into detail. He like puts your eyes over each other. Anybody out there, just go to YouTube and just do Bill Hicks is Alex Jones, and you'll see all these videos.
Well, you know, we're getting desperate. We're getting desperate is while we're talking about this, right? This is damage control, Kevin.
Yeah.
All right, folks. No, for the family. I'm not gonna joke around about this. I am not Bill Hicks. Okay. I'm actually Bill Clinton's son. All right, we're going to be... No, it's true, folks. Okay, we're going to get serious, get into the drug war straight ahead with Kevin Booth, American Drug War II. Kevin Booth grew up in Houston, Texas. He was a teenager. Him and Bill Hicks were best friends. That's why we're getting into Bill Hicks. And I want to get into your new film and hold you a little bit in the next hour because I got you on late. Larry Pinkney, one of the founders of the Black Panther Party, is going to be in studio with us. He's also going to be on the nightly news tonight, and we're here interviewing him for a film I'm making. But congratulations on American Drug War being, I've seen it in a lot of newspapers, cited as something that's really exposed the drug wars, the fraud it is, aired on a lot of the big cable networks, big hit. American Drug War II, I've talked to people that have seen it, say it is a unrivaled masterpiece and blows the first one away. I mean, well, you probably are 6-7 years, correct me if I'm wrong, in the making of this. I know how that is when you really want to make a real film and you just get obsessed with it. He moved out to L.A. to really cover the drug war more closely to make American Drug War II. I think you told me it's been picked up by Warner Brothers. It's going to be in select theaters across the country. Very important to be a hit in theaters so it gets expanded everywhere. But this gets into what it does to children, American Drug War II. And so we will be breaking that down and playing some exclusive video audio clips never before seen here today ahead of its release. We're going to get into that. But since we bring up Bill Hicks... Talk about growing up a little bit briefly with Bill Hicks, being his first producer with stuff like Ninja Bachelor Party and so much more. And then, of course, you told me the story privately. I think it's also in the best-selling book that came out later about, you know, being there the day he died of pancreatic cancer. you know, I'm not afraid to die, but I've got so much work I want to do. And Bill had so much work. He was so young. I mean, just a few minutes on Bill Hicks, remembering him.
Okay. God, I never know what to expect to come on when I come on here. You're all serious, then you get all funny on me. It's like a roller coaster ride. You know, I mean, that's an interesting thing because, I mean, you're going 100 miles an hour, and basically Bill was never a guy that wasted any time. And when he would be around people that wasted his time or just wanted to hang out, he would usually, like, bolt and go do his own thing. He was trying to achieve things. But definitely once Bill was diagnosed with cancer, instead of running around and telling everybody, he didn't want people to feel sorry for him. And he didn't want people to coddle him, and he definitely didn't want his life to slow down. So he kept it a complete secret, even from me for a long time, and basically just cranked up the volume, and he got as much done as possible before he passed away. And the whole time when he was sick, you know, it was believed he was going to pull through. I mean, you know, we're all praying for this miracle, and for a while the tumor markers were looking better. But we literally, he got sick while we were working on an album called Arizona Bay in my home studio. It was an album where we were doing music and comedy together. And we did Rant in E Minor while he was sick. We worked on a brand new Ninja Bachelor Party. We did a bunch of TV shows and interviews. And he was, we were working on a pilot for a TV show for Channel 4 in England called Council of the Netherworld. And so Bill, even though he was extremely sick, probably in a lot of pain, he was just running to the finish line and knowing that this was going to be the legacy that he left behind on Earth, whatever that was.
Incredible. Amazing comedian, amazing political mind. It's just a ride. All right, Kevin, shifting gears into your film.
Are you rolling? You ready for this? I can't believe it's come to this, but they cornered me. I've got to be honest. It's gotten too big. I've just got to admit it right now. Okay. This is just really hard for me to do. I've been doing this so long, it's hard to give up. Give up on the character and go back to who I really was. You got me, okay? Are you happy now? You bastards. Yes, I am Bill Hicks. Or to be more accurate, you didn't get it all, did you? You didn't get the full conspiracy. I played the character, Bill Hicks, for 15 years with my accomplice, Kevin Booth. And we fooled you all. The master actor, the master genius. And then I decided to bring forward an even more incredible persona, that of Alex Jones. But here's where the rest of the story comes in. For 20 years, I've been Alex Jones, since we staged my death in the early 1990s. The truth is that Bill Hicks himself never existed, and now I'm going to reveal my true identity.